All right. Welcome back, everybody. Sports Chat 503. Man, thank you guys very much for watching. First time, long time. Either way, I appreciate it. I'm coming to you live from Portland, Oregon, all the way tucked up in the northwest corner of the world. And I want to talk about college football. I love college football. I like to break down everything from the college to the pros, everywhere in between. But college football is my absolute favorite sport going on right now. And this one is kind of a little top 25. About halfway through the season, we'll start transitioning and start looking at who's in the top four, who could be in the top four. But right now, let's just talk about this week, what happened, and then we'll talk about next week. Big games, the normal little deal. Let's get in and out, folks. Alabama, Bama, 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 Bama. Bama's kicking some serious butt in the SEC. They are letting people know that they should be the number one team in the country every year for the next 100 years, and nobody should ever question it. But next week they play Texas A&M. A&M is always a tough team for Bama. I think, you know, last week they beat Ole Miss 118-1. And this week they play at Texas A&M. And you know what? Texas A&M, they might only beat 70-4, but still, that's a battle, okay? Now, let's go Clemson. Clemson, man, oh man, oh man. Clemson's a team that has that whole, can the team come back when they're the champs? Can the champs stir it up again? Can they get fired up enough to go do it again? I think that Clemson can. But I do think that Clemson's a little bit tough in that ACC. I think the ACC might be harder to win than the SEC. I know that might sound like a crazy hot take. I'm trying to get clicks just like First Take and all those other people. But I'm not. The ACC is a really good conference top to bottom. I feel like the SEC is kind of great at Alabama and Georgia. But I thought LSU got beat by Troy this week. The SEC is overrated. Everybody's said this for years. That doesn't mean Bama is. Bama's like a vampire to the SEC. Bama's been so good, they've sucked everything else out of the SEC and left it basically everybody's kind of like Vanderbilt was 4 or 5 years ago. Clemson, on the other hand, they've got a whole slew. Mark Richt is down in Miami. What was the thing? What's it called? Pastor Gables or something? With the, it's got this nice elitist gated community kind of name. Miami feels like it's getting back to running. Florida State's always good. One of the best in the country every single year. North Carolina, they don't even have to go to school to get the freaking thing happening there. I mean, you can have aliens play on that team and the NCAA would look the other way. Okay, you got Virginia Tech in that thing. Obviously, Virginia's not that big of a deal, but you got some teams that you got to play in the ACC, and Clemson has to go through that sort of a little bit of a slug. I think that right now, you might want to say that it's harder to win the ACC. Give it to Clemson, right? Clemson plays Wake next week. They'll crush. Oklahoma had a bye. Perfect timing to kind of just rest up. They play at Iowa State next week. No, they just play at, they play at home. Thank the Lord, because they don't want to play up there. They'll beat Iowa State. Penn State. Penn State might have the Heisman Trophy winner. That kid is amazing. And he even had a throw, a little touchdown at the end of the game. They gave him the chance to throw it. That was great. So they beat Indiana. They're going to play Northwestern. They're going to roll. And then Georgia. Georgia crushes the Volunteers. Tennessee, every year it feels like people want them to be good, and then they just don't really show up the right way you want them to. Tennessee, whatever. But next week you got Vanderbilt. Oh, yeah, I just said Vanderbilt's awesome. So Georgia keeps winning. Washington beats Oregon State, which is just an absolute terrible team. And then this next week they play California. They're better, but not that much better. You got Michigan plays Michigan State. Always a battle. Michigan State's not as good as they used to be. TCU at West Virginia, that's a tough one. Give it to TCU, though. They've got the 29th ranked defense in the country. Oregon Ducks have the 30th ranked team. Amazing right now, people. Wisconsin, I don't even know how they're ranking Ohio State this low. It's like they're trying to punish them by ranking them 16th in the country or whatever the hell they are right now, 10th. I think they're going to roll. I think they only lose one game this year. I could be crazy, but I think Ohio State's going to be right in the thick of it by the end of the deal. Washington State got a huge win against USC. That was obviously epic, and that threw USC behind them, and now we have nobody besides Washington anywhere close in the ranking, but that's how it goes. And then you have Auburn. Auburn is a weird team, you know. Auburn, I think, has a chance to win, but they didn't look that great earlier on in the year. Miami's looking better. We've talked about Oklahoma State. Oklahoma State had that one loss. Granted, it was to a better team that one time, but I think Oklahoma State might be the best one-loss team in the country. And then you got teams like Louisville, who, you know, are great to watch on like a Thursday night. They're fun, but it's not really like going to compete with the championship. And then Notre Dame's in the top 25. How about that? So congratulations, everybody. All right, that's it for me. Other than that, you don't really have that much great going on next week. So watch what you can. I guess TCU West Virginia is your best game. All right, folks. Watch my other videos if you want to watch them. If not, go watch other stuff on YouTube. There's like thousands of videos loaded every minute. All right. Thank you guys for watching. Adios.